Part 2. Verdant Wind. Blue Sea Moon. The City Without Light. Immediately following Edelgard's defeat, the Alliance Army discovers the existence of another adversary, a group operating behind the scenes within the Empire. Claude suspects that if the true enemy is left unchecked, disaster will befall Fodlan, and so he cuts short the celebration and the troops head for Shambhala, where this foe resides.
I just don't get it.
What is it, Claude?
Those javelins of light. They were trying to use it to kill us at Fort Mercius, right? But then why not drop it on Garrig Mach? They must have known for a while that we were here.
It is not that they chose to refrain, but rather that they were unable to do so.
Rhea, how are you feeling?
I am well enough. I cannot afford to rest while Fodlan is in danger.
What do you mean when you say they couldn't drop a javelin of light here?
Once, a very long time ago, a massive ball of light fell upon this monastery. However, that light mysteriously changed course in mid-air and landed in Aelel instead.
Aelel, the Valley of Torment. So that's what the wreckage of those javelins of light looks like.
The Holy Tomb is not only the location of the progenitor god's eternal slumber, but also a sacred vessel for a power that repels evil. Supposedly, the progenitor god built the Holy Tomb herself to protect her children from the evil light.
So the children of the goddess gathered in Xanadu because of its proximity to the monastery? But we've fought at distant locations many times.
Despite that, the javelins of light only fell on Fort Mercius.
In his letter, Hubert said that he detected their magic when the fort fell. In other words, because they used a javelin of light, Hubert was able to pinpoint the location of their base.
So they didn't use it before then because they didn't want us to know where their base is?
In any case, those javelins of light must be something they can't just use whenever they want. And they finally decided to use one at Mercius, where they were sure they'd be able to finish us off. It's only thanks to the whims of the Death Knight that we escaped with our lives. And no javelins of light have fallen since then.
It's possible that the enemy hasn't yet realized that we've learned the location of their base.
If so, their guard may be down, which makes this the perfect time for a surprise attack.
I will accompany you.
What? No! That would be far too dangerous! Your long confinement weakened you greatly, did it not?
Those people have opposed us since ancient times. I wish to learn the truth about them for myself.
I understand. I will not stop you, but please take care not to overexert yourself.
We don't know exactly what we're up against here, but having you around is very reassuring, Rhea. Let's prepare to strike at Shambhala before they make their next move.
Relying on a map entrusted to them by Hubert, The Alliance Army sets their sights on the base belonging to those who slither in the dark. Beyond its entrance, they are met by a sprawling underground city.
Incredible! Who knew that there was such a vast space beneath the ground?
It's like an underground city. I've never seen buildings like these before.
It's like an ancient ruin, but not just because of its appearance.
I don't recall ever seeing architecture like this.
It is magnificent in a sense, but I could hardly call it beautiful. Even the air feels stagnant.
In any case, it seems like we need to go deeper. Let's look around and see if we can find some stairs.
No. It is simply, we must defeat those who slither in the dark, no matter what happens. But if my conjecture is correct, the one who they will wish to kill the most is you, dear child. They are aware that you can use the sword of the Creator. Your body houses the same power they once bestowed upon Nemesis. That is why I fear for you. Perhaps. Please forgive my errant thoughts. Once this battle is over, I will explain everything. I will tell you all I know about who you really are.
Thank you. thousands of years, we have existed underground, living on only that we might someday see our vengeance realized. Here and now, that vengeance is finally within our grasp. There is but one thing left to do. Destroy them! Damn those who stand with that arrogant goddess to oblivion, away from the world of the living! Now is the time. Remove the binding spell of Titanus. Let their metal bodies be drenched in blood!
Hey, what are those big things?
Demonic beasts? No, I think not. They appear to have no will of their own. Someone must be controlling them.
Initiate all that remain! We must advance our preparations!
I'll do my best! I will prevail.
At the ready. A fitting outcome.
Let's make this quick. It's done. All in a day's work.
I'd be honored.
Steady now.
My orders?
What's my strategy? Another victory. I'm awake.
Shall we? Never let your guard down.
Shall we?
Let's go.
Ah!
I must always improve.
Can't afford to slack off.
Decent form.
But I'm with you.
Viscum activated. Increase output gradually, depending on the amount of magical energy charged. I don't care if we destroy Shambhala, so long as our goals are fulfilled.
Appreciate it.
Strength is all for a mercenary.
Don't get used to this.
I've gotten stronger.
You're a big help. Thank you.
If only progress didn't require so much work.
At the ready.
Yeah.
I'm here to help.
Come, I have an idea.
Too close for my liking.
Me of all people. Really?
Yet. If only sales were this good. I'm sorry.
was the only way.
Time to slow down.
This'll get him.
Let's try something.
There's a way forward. I want to learn even more.
Hold a grudge if you must.
I fought and won.
A curtsy. I'm impressed.
no way I can lose here.
Big things have gone to sleep on us. That'll make moving around a lot easier. A dead end? Or perhaps... No, if we worry about every little detail, we won't get anywhere.
Finished. Forcibly increase Viscom's output!
He seems to be issuing orders to that facility. If we destroy it, perhaps that will stop those weapons. Those awful weapons have been stopped. They were being controlled from that facility.
You!
That is the leader of those who slither in the dark. We must go after him with all of our might!
Thank you.
yours!
I work to grow. Press on. I'm sorry. Now there's a way forward.
Amazing. I wasn't about to let you go.
I'll tolerate no obstacle.
More effective.
Yeah. It was a team effort. Could be useful.
That's what you get. People are waiting on me.
Had I room to grow?
Pushing myself. That's enough. Sorry, but it's you or me.
Apologies.
You're nothing but animals, performing tricks in the hopes of pleasing the goddess. You will never see the sunlight again!
I know a good deal when I see it.
What's my strategy?
So you have shown yourself, Felstar. Or should I say, Sophis? I will spill every drop of blood in your body to fulfill the long-standing goal of the Agarthans.
Now's our chance. At the ready.
Ha! It is laughable that base animals such as you would bear fangs at the likes of us.
I may be a base animal, but I have strong allies. Do you think you can beat Teach and the Sword of the Creator?
The Sword of the Creator. The blade given to Nemesis. Who do you really think is superior?
There's a big difference between the living and the dead. The fate of the future lies in the hands of the living. Pull out all the stops. Let's go.
You're nothing but animals! Yeah.
I've gotten stronger, haven't I? Hang in there, Lady Rhea. Get her to her room, quickly!
That's a serious injury. It's a miracle that she's even alive right now. I'll do what I can, but...
Goddess, please save Lady Rhea. All we can do now is pray.
Remember when this place was taken 5 years ago and a pure white beast appeared on the battlefield? I only caught a glimpse of it, but I didn't understand where it came from. There were rumors that the goddess sent it to protect the monastery. But now I know better. That beast was Rhea. Did you know Rhea's true identity? I once showed you a picture of a creature known as the Immaculate One. Sedith confiscated it, saying it must have been one of Tomas's personal possessions. The beast that appeared back then looked just like it. So Rhea is the Immaculate One. The book said that it was a servant of the goddess, but wouldn't it make sense if beasts like that are actually children of the goddess? Rhea is in a grim state right now. It's possible she may not make it, but we have things we must ask her about. Once things calm down a little, let's go and see Rhea. Together, the truth can't be delayed any longer.